My favourite makeup that I've done, we did a horror film and there was a lot of blood involved, and just it was great fun to just kind of get my free reign to just go mental. I'm Alex Kell and I'm a makeup artist for independent films in Scotland. I do a lot of different makeups. I do prosthetics, I do day-to-day makeup, everything in between, blood, guts and gory, kind of my favourite, I'm not going to lie. My favourite makeup that I've done, we did a horror film and there was a lot of blood involved, and just it was great fun to just kind of get my free reign to just go mental with the blood and the guts and the gore. Best way for me to prepare for something like that is get the brief, figure out my time span and things like that, and then just Google real life images, go and look them up. And like, I've got friends, if they go through something or if they get a cut in their hand, they will literally send me pictures for days so I can see how it's healing and things like that. I just keep those kind of things as reference so that if I am ever asked to do something like that, I've got it there. I can recreate that because I sit with any spare time I've got literally playing about trying to figure things out and trying to make sure that I'm always trying the new and kind of latest products that are available so that I've got that product knowledge that I can then bring. So on the film, I need to kind of liaise with the director, find out what he's wanting, he or she is wanting, find out what kind of things I'm needing, where we're going with this, so that I'm putting their vision across as best as possible. It's just whatever's needed of me. I can do, I've got quite a range, so I can do quite a lot, just whatever is kind of asked. I went to see Wicked in Edinburgh, and it literally was like a spur of the moment thing. Just booked a ticket, went by myself, and I was like literally up in the nosebleed seats and just saw all the makeup and ended up paying like £40 for the book that shows you how to do the makeup, and that was me. I was like hooked, absolutely hooked. It's probably the smaller things I find more challenging, like tiny little cuts and things like that, because you've not got all the prosthetics and the kind of big theatrical things to hide behind. It is literally just your talent and your ability to kind of manipulate such a small area, and I find that the most challenging rather than the big pieces, because you can just hide them in blood. My goal to be doing something like Game of Thrones, or I don't know, just something that means working with blood every single day, because that would be my dream. Not every little girl's dream, but it's mine.